Okay, I'm going to show an example of a minimum cover application with the depth check. So what we're going to do is, the first thing is we want to make sure our machine's planted. So planted by planted I mean that the blade is down, avoiding that helps you avoid rocking and any movement to the machine that could inadvertently affect the accuracy of depth check. So with a minimum cover application, all I want to achieve is a minimum cover of, in this case, 12 inches relative to the surface. So as I move along the job site, even though the elevation rises or drops, I really don't care about that. All I care is that I sustain and keep at a 12-inch digging depth for my trench. And so obviously then the bottom of my trench is not going to be level, but that's not a concern here. All we care about, be it for cable or electric or gas, some of these of course would be deeper than that. But so what I'm going to do is of course go to the depth check, and I'm going to set my depth target at 12 inches. And then I'm going to lower the bucket onto the area where I'll be digging, and bench. And again, that's the number one button on the panel. The key with benching, be it for minimum cover or for sustaining a grade, you always bench what I refer to as in the trench, in line with your trench. You do not bench to the side. You do not bench to the rear. So I have now benched. The screen is telling me my target is 12 inches, current depth is zero, and my distance to target is 12 inches. So I'm going to start digging now. Now with depth check, you want to avoid any movement of the machine, if possible, to sustain your accuracy. So instead of chasing right towards 12 inches, what I'm going to do is strip the surface down to my target and not worry about whether I'm close or at or near my target until I start to hear the warning beep. And I'm starting to hear the warning beep now. That tells me I'm getting close, so I'm a little more careful when I'm digging now. The slow chirp is telling me that I'm slightly above my target. And I'll be even more careful on this pass. It's telling me my teeth are in fact right at or near target. And so I'm going to be very careful on the dig now. I'm solid tone. That tells me I'm at target. And I'm hoping this will be my last pass, so I'll use extra care to follow for the solid tone. For a brief moment, I heard a fast chirp. That meant my teeth were slightly beyond target. So my last pass, I want to be as close as I can to target, because once I back up, it's very difficult to reach that. I'm comfortable with where I've left that trench. Now I'm going to raise my blade and I'm going to back up to a point where I can still reach back to where I had stopped trenching. I'll drop my blade, make sure my machine is positioned. I'll lower down, touch my teeth on the surface. And again, I will bench. And that's a process you will do, again, every time you move the machine, you have to rebench.